battle some problem in which we can't solve on our own. Every hour of the day is filled with decisions that must be made. And to the most part, most of us find ourselves ill-equipped to make these decisions. Therefore, we find ourselves searching for someone who has the ability to advise us in the right way to lead us, and when we don't know how to lead ourselves, to comfort us in the midst of our distresses, to help us solve the problems that we can't solve on our own. Well, y'all still sit here kind of sophisticated. James Allworth, sophisticated. Let me just say it this way. I need somebody.
Yes.
I need someone to direct my life, to manage my affairs. I need someone who has the all-around know-how to look out for me when I ain't got sense enough to look out for myself.
Yes.
I need somebody to do things for me that I can't do for myself. In a sense, I want to employ me or take over me. That I can trust, that's gonna do all the right things, make all the right decisions, lead me in all the right directions. I wanna be able to turn my life over to him and rest 100% sure that he's gonna make all the right decisions for my life. I need somebody.
Come on, brother.
Well,
come on, brother.
When the word got out, I was looking for a manager for my life.
Yes, sir.
I received what I want to classify as two resumes from two entities or two candidates interested in the job of managing my life.
Come on, brother.
Yeah.
Now, I don't mean to insult nobody's intelligence this morning.
Okay. Come on, bro, come on.
But just for the sake of the record, a resume is just simply a summary or an outline of one's experiences, ability, or skills. That's all a resume is. It's just an outline. It's a summary of a person's abilities or skills or their education. First one I received was from a fella who was referred to by many titles. Lucifer. The devil. The prince of this world. Beelzebub. But his real name is Satan. Yes, he informed me that he was interested in the job of managing my life. Well, now I got to admit, y'all, at first I was first impressed when I looked at his resume because of all the lucrative promises in which he made. I was interested. Because look, he told me, he said, you can enter in at the wide gate, and you can travel the broad way. He told me, you'll always be in the midst of a fun, loving crowd. He said, you can lie, you can cheat, you can steal, you can commit adultery, you can have it better than Burger King. And he told me, I can have it my way.
Come on.
I was kind of impressed, but he neglected to tell me.
Come on, Taylor.
He was kind of like one of the candidates.
Come on, Taylor.
They got a lot of promises, but no details. he didn't tell me. All that hot air you were blowing, he neglected to tell me at the end of that hot air was a hot hell. Another thing I didn't like about his resume, he didn't list no references. Evidently, he didn't want me talking to nobody he didn't work for.
Come on,
to be sure about the person that's going to manage my life.
Sir.
Yeah.
You know, when I checked the records, I found out.
Come on, Taylor.
This fella got kicked out of heaven for trying to take God's place.
Amen.
He said something when I asked about his name, Lucy said, well, you know, I was in the light business. But when I found out he got kicked out, he got fined.
Come on,
Taylor.
I discovered he told the first lie that was ever told and been lied.
I got to.
You get excited because somebody got some position or something.
Yeah.
But I got to be like the fella was.
Uh-huh.
If he haven't read the Holy Bible.
Yeah.
Let me play your Bible.
Come on, Jay.
Y'all remember the fella? Christian folk, if you ain't read it, I'll loan you Valentine's.
Good.
The Bible says, what profit a man if he should gain the whole world, mess around?
What is that?
I discovered he was a deceiver. Uh-huh. And his job is to deceive the whole world.
Yeah.
He's an impostor. The Bible says Satan has transformed himself into an angel of light. But thanks be God, I tell you.
Come on, John.
And I kept checking the record.
Come on, John.
I discovered this fella already been judged.
Uh-huh.
He's already been judged.
Uh-huh.
His head has already been crushed.
Come on.
He's hell bound and trying to take as many for the wood as he can.
That's right.
Now, you know, you've been around me for a little while.
Uh-huh.
I hope y'all picked up I got a little conversation.
That's right.
All right.
I guess y'all know. I mean, y'all heard of 513.
Uh-huh.
Y'all heard of Trash Can.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's what I did with his resume.
Come on, bro.
I began looking over the other resume which I had received.
Uh-huh.
Now, I got to say I was kind of puzzled. At first, I really didn't know if it was a resume or what it was.
Come on, bro.
It was a dress. It had my address, but it didn't have a name. It was addressed to whosoever will.
Yeah.
All right.
Now the power right now. I tell you, and it didn't have.
Come on.
And only you.
Uh-huh.
Cover them.
Uh-huh.
Which are the words of the text?
Right.
Come unto me.
All right.
All ye that labor
and
are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Amen.
Oh yeah, I tell you, had an unusual cover letter. And the person that sent that resume, he was referred to by many titles also.
Yeah.
He's been referred to as wonderful.
Yeah. All right.
Counselor.
Yes, sir.
The mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, but his real name is Jesus.
Come on.
At least that's the name that appears on his birth certificate. On his resume, he listed his birthplace as being Bethlehem of Judea. Now I got to admit, there were some circumstances surrounding his birth that were not too impressive. Yes, because instead of him being born in a hospital, he was born in a stable.
Right.
Instead of them laying him in a bassinet, they laid him in a manger.
Right.
Instead of them using pampers, they wrapped him in swaddling.
Amen.
But I tell you why these things didn't impress me. There were some other things surrounding his birthday deed. When he was born, wise men traveled from afar just to see where King Jesus lay. When he was born, heaven suspended its choir in the midst of the air. peace on earth, goodwill toward men. I tell you, when he was born, some unusual things happened.
Then I noticed something else on his resume.
He listed four different birthdays as to the time he was born.
Right. He says his mother's record said he was born around 4 B.C.
That's right.
But his daddy's record said,
that's right,
man. He said, before Abraham was,
I am. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then that's what he said, from everlasting to everlasting, thou art.
Amen.
Yeah, did not look further. I was really interested in where he went to school.
Yeah.
Where he got his training.
Yeah.
You see, come on, bro. Come on,
bro. The only school I could find, y'all, was a little vocational school in Nashville. It wasn't even recognized by the Board of Education. The only teacher he had was his daddy, Joseph. It was a cop in the shop. And at first, that kind of disturbed me, but I kept on reading the record. And I discovered at the age of 12, he stayed in Jerusalem and he was talking with doctors and lawyers. He puzzled them at the age of 12. So it don't bother me now because Jesus, even though he did not attend one of the prestigious universities of that day, even though he did not assimilate with the best, I got to tell you, he's a scholar in his own right.
Amen.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
One night he had a night school.
With Nicodemus.
Yeah. When he got through, Nicodemus found out he needed a real BA degree.
He needed to be born again.
That's right.
The next thing I noticed, he listed some skills. Now I got to looking at this real closely, y'all.
Come on,
he listed himself as a doctor that never lost the patient. And
he lists a reference. He refers to the woman that had the issue of blood for 12 long years.
Right,
now know the story, don't
right,
you?
Yes.
How she just pressed her way through the crowd and how she had enough faith to reach out and touch him. And when she did, Jesus said, somebody touch me.
Right.
The disciples said, man, it could have been anybody. He said, you don't understand. Somebody touched me by faith.
Right.
I felt virtue. I felt healing by somebody got something out of my drug.
He referred not only to her, but he referred to the man and lady at the pool of Bethesda.
Y'all know the story, don't you? How
he laid there for 38 long years. Jesus came by one day and said, will thou
be made whole? The man said, sir, I have nobody.
Yeah.
I gotta put a pin in right there for just a minute. Jesus did not ask him who he had. Jesus asked him, do you want him be made whole? Why, when God is at the brink of wanting to bless us with the blessings that we need, we want to talk about who we ain't got. We want to talk about how bad folk have done us. But I want you to know, you need to just listen to Jesus. He said, do you want to be home? Just tell the Lord, yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. About what you ain't got.
Well,
or how folks treat you. Just answer Jesus' question. Do you want me? Y'all got no story.
Yeah.
That's what he did. He referred.
Come on.
He said he's a doctor.
All right.
Never lost a faith. Then he said he's a lawyer. Never lost a case. He refers to the woman that caught in the very act of adultery.
Amen.
That's what they did. They caught up.
Y'all, they fly.
Yeah.
They follow that. Yeah, they set it up.
Y'all know they did. You know how to catch folks. In that act. They should set it up.
Yeah.
They had it set. smiling because you ain't no big cough. But Jesus fixed that when he came. He said, no, it's hard to catch some of y'all sleepers. Some of y'all midnight creepers. Jesus said, he that looking for no woman. Blessed in his heart. Is good God Almighty.
Amen.
But they called her, y'all. Uh-huh. They called in the act.
Yeah.
They called her red.
Red.
They brought her to Jesus. They said, Jesus, we want you to be the public defender.
Yeah.
And what you got to say about this?
Come on, bro.
Jesus didn't say one word. He just looped down in the ground. Started scribbling.
Yeah.
I promise y'all, I don't know what he scribbled. But whatever it was, the front room got clean.
Yeah.
And when Jesus got through scripture, he turned around, wasn't nobody but the woman that, he said, woman, where are thou thine accused? She said, Lord, I have not. Jesus said, neither do I go and sin no more. He said, he's a lawyer that never lost a case. And the Bible said he never lost a case. He said, because his daddy is the judge.
Amen.
He said he's a dietitian. Uh-huh. I know we got some good cooks around here.
Uh-huh.
But can't none of y'all do what Jesus did.
Amen.
He's a dietitian that took two fish.
Uh-huh.
Five barley loaves.
Yeah.
Fed 5,000, not count women. And you, y'all got to read
right.
This.
Yeah.
Y'all, I just want y'all to read this get off. Y'all need to really read that one sometime.
Right.
We always talk about Jesus fed that 5,000.
Right.
Jesus was, he could do the impossible. But now, if you were written, know, he fed the 5,000 through the disciples.
Amen.
Oh, see, we sit back and want Jesus to do everything.
Right.
The disciples didn't even think they had enough.
Yeah.
Jesus said, man, them said, first of all, get busy working with what you get.
Amen, amen.
Good.
We don't want to do nothing unless we got 5,000 loaves.
That's right.
Come on. A fish market full of fish. He said he's a dietitian.
Yeah.
Then I tell you what else, another thing I was interested in, y'all, was his marital status. See, I'm married.
Okay, yeah.
I really need somebody to help me with Sister Taylor, y'all.
Okay.
I always wondered if he was married, I had any children.
Okay.
I found out to my utter surprise that he's engaged to be married.
All right.
And his bride is the church.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And I, as far as children, like I said, I discovered every time a sinner make up his mind, for God I live and for God I die, a child is added to his family.
Yeah.
He loves his bride to be. He protects her too. Y'all don't believe me.
Amen.
He slipped the engagement ring on a finger that day he boarded that cloud. And they watched him leave as sin up into heaven. And they said, the same Jesus you see leaving, he coming back.
Yeah.
In like manner. Amen. But now, every time his bride to be have got in trouble,
He
always came to her defense.
Yeah.
I remember one day old Saul was going down the Damascus road headed to persecute his bride to be. He didn't like that too well. The Bible said a light from heaven shined brighter than the noonday sun knocked him from his peace.
Yeah.
I tell you, he will take care
of
his bride to be.
Yeah.
That's why I'm glad I'm in the church.
Because
Jesus is going to look out for his church.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you want to get in a safe place, don't go to Walmart, but get in the church. And y'all ain't hearing me.
Yeah.
Come on. He's always protected her from her horrible danger.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't you glad fire can't burn?
Amen.
Water can't drown.
Amen.
Put it in the ground, it'll rise again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I got to tell y'all, all of this sounded and looked good.
I discovered one thing about
resumes, most of them do look good.
That's right.
On paper.
Yeah.
They look good on paper, but if you really want to find out if a person is capable of doing a job, you really need to check for some of the references.
That's right. There you go.
Jesus.
That's right, Doc.
Mr. Peter, James and John, Mary, and Martha, and a host of us.
That's right.
But I decided I want to contact some of these fellows myself. I decided to contact Peter. As a Peter of Jesus, this person, the job of managing my life, what you got? I said, Peter got talking so much, I'll go ahead and tell him to shut up. He said, man, you talk about Jesus, if you can get him, you better get him. Why?
Why you can?
Why you can? If you in business, he'll be business partner. He let me tell you, one night we was out fishing all night, had taken absolutely nothing. Jesus showed up on the bank telling me to lunch out of the deep. Y'all got to understand something now. Peter was a fisherman before Jesus came along. That was his livelihood. Jesus, I know you told me you're going to make me become fishers of men, but right now I ain't fishing for men. I'm fishing for fish. Jesus said, lunch out. Into the deep. He had the good sense to say, nevertheless, at thy word. He said, man, when we did that, I ain't never seen nothing like it. We took in more fish, my neck break. He said, first of all, I was half-hearted about obeying. He was. Y'all do know he didn't fully obey Jesus. Jesus said, let down your nets, plural.
Amen.
He let down one net. And I'm afraid of reading a lot of those ain't got the blessing God want us to have. Because when he tell us to let down our nets, we get a little frigid and we just let down
one.
But why don't you do it like the Lord said? He said, Leon, if you want to get you, man, you better get him wild. While you can. I said, I had to contact James and John. I said, Jesus won't the man in my life. He said, Leon, let me tell you. Our story is, you better get it. Because in this life, you're going to have some storm. Lightning going to flash. Wind going to blow. Thunder going to roll. One night we was out on the stormy sea. Lightning start flashing. Thunder start rolling. Wind start blowing. We thought we were sure gone. But one of us had something to remember. Jesus was on the ship. Somebody had something to wake him up. He woke up, walked up, spoke up, and everything shut up. If you want somebody that can quiet a mighty storm, Jesus can just say, peace, peace still, and storm will subside. He listed Mary and Martha. Now I gotta tell you on my own set, and I'm gonna get out of here.
Okay.
What they told me really helped me make up my mind. I said, Jesus want a man in my life. Man, you better get Jesus. You better get all of you can. They said, we had a brother named Lazarus. We sent for Jesus. But now, Leon, let me tell you something. Don't get disheartened when you're calling sometimes. And he don't come when you want him. Just wait on him. Keep it on time. Whenever he shows up. He said, well, good God Almighty, Leon, let us tell you, he had been dead 4 days. And Jesus finally showed up. And I ran out and said, Lord, if you'd have just been here, my brother wouldn't have died. Jesus said, you gonna see your brother again. He said, Lord, I know I will one by in the sweet lies by. when the morning comes, in the last day, and in the resurrection. She said, wait a minute, baby. You don't know who you're talking to. I am the resurrection. I am the life. Show me where you laid him. Yeah, you gotta know the story. Jesus went out to raise out loud, called Lazarus by his name. Lazarus from the floor. And Lazarus got up, started coming out, bound and wrapped in grave clothes. Jesus spoke to his grave clothes, said, loose the man and let him go. I tell you what they told me helped me make up my mind. Because I found out we didn't come here to stay. And if I can get somebody, they can come out. You know, my mom and I buried in a cemetery called Rosewood up in Humboldt, Tennessee. It's good for me to have somebody man in my life that's able to speak and stuff at Rosewood start shaking up. One day and I just get up, change and a twinkle in an eye, and meet my master in the sky. I tell you, I need somebody like that in my life. Well, I'm out of here, y'all.
Come on, Dave. Come on,
Dave. But not only that, a baker showed me he was the bread of life.
Yeah.
An astrologer told me he's the bright and the morning star. A pharmacologist told me he got more medicine in the hymn of his God than all the drugstores in the world. An engineer told me he's a bridge over troubled water. Fortune told me he's a precious stone hewn out of the mountain. Officer told me he's a captain that never lost a battle. Old sea captain told me he's the captain of the old ship of Zion. Well, I'm finna get out of here, y'all, but there was one more thing that I wanted to check before giving Jesus the job. Imagine my life. I found out he had a Polish record. Yeah, and I decided I needed to do a background check. And when I started checking the record, they set up a kangaroo court. Yeah, criminal court, night court open. They marched him from hall to hall one Thursday night. And they heard one Friday he died. I say he died. One Friday he died. But I thought that was all over. I asked myself, if he's dead, how can I give him the job? I'll manage my life. decided to make Jesus my choice. Hey, all right. He said, you gotta be born again.
Yeah.
He said, I can't work for you.
Yeah.
Unless you've been born. Get the doors of the church open. Ain't he good?
Yeah.
Ain't he good?
Yeah.
The doors open. Turn it over to Jesus. I know.